Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, wherever you are. It's 97 degrees here in Austin, Texas, and I'm at a very, very special place, a very crowded place. I've been invited to the grand opening of this special Porsche, the largest Porsche dealership in Austin, Texas. I am friends with the owner's son, the owner's family, the owner's next door neighbor, and anyone who knows the owner. So I am very excited to be here. I'm gonna do my best to give you a tour of the inside of the dealership. It is very crowded inside. There's a lot to see. Wish me luck. Today is Thursday, the 26th. I'm sorry, yesterday I got my dates. Mixed up. Yesterday was Wednesday, not Thursday. Today's Thursday and yesterday was Wednesday. So wish me luck. Here I go. It is very crowded inside and we'll see if we can show you inside without getting molested. This is a huge facility. Perhaps I'll show you some of the vehicles outside first. Or maybe not. Maybe I'll just go inside. It's awful hot today. And like I said, I've been inside and it is crowded. It is very, very crowded. There's an Aston Martin, a Porsche SUV. These are some of the vehicles out front. Look at this. This is a Ferrari. Mini Cooper station wagon. A Boxer. Holy cow. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Another Porsche four-door. Some of the valet staff. Hello, fellas. What a place, huh?
Yeah, absolutely.
And this is a vintage. What year would you say this one was? Maybe 79. Maybe. Wow, 1979. They call this the bathtub. Mercedes-Benz, Porsche. I tried to park my vehicle over here, but they rejected the 1991 Toyota pickup. Porsche, nice color scheme, orange. Another Porsche SUV. And then we have some electric vehicles over here, very interesting. Another Porsche Turbo. Wow, look at these vehicles. My God, just bring money. Just bring money and an Audi. Okay, this is a huge facility. Let's just get it over with, see how we do and go inside. This might be a long video. It might be a very, very short video. Who knows? But I'm gonna try to give you the best views and best images I can, considering where I am. And we'll go right in the red carpet, right out front. And we'll see if, wow, look at that one, huh? Big engine, big engine. There he goes, that's a stick shift. That's a standard. A stick shift is called a standard as opposed to your automatic. Okay, let's go. Let's go right in. Temperature check. Thank you so much for your hospitality. Thank you. Okay, let's start with the vehicles. And just a huge, huge selection of vehicles for you ladies and gentlemen who like skiing. Nice color red. Although they say red attracts the police, you're more inclined to be pulled over for speeding in a red vehicle than you are in a different color vehicle. That's what I'm told. Beautiful vehicles. Beautiful showroom. Multi-floored. Multi-lights. These vehicles are a little bit above, I would say quite a bit above my pay grade. And I think I'll go get another drink. Hi, can I have another one of those soda waters with the grape cranberry?
You have the cranberry juice in it?
Yeah. Yes. You can really try one on here. I mean, this is just, everywhere you look is a watering hole. A lot of the executives, the Porsche executives. Wow, thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you for your hospitality. Just kind of wander around here. There's the DJ. Oh, I'll have a meatball. Can I put this down first? This is first class. Thank you, sir. That was a meatball. The DJ booth. Wow, nice. Thank you for your hospitality. Here's a Porsche bicycle. Wow. Okay. The Porsche bicycle is the cross model is $8,549. And the e-bike is $10,700. Not bad. Not bad. Just high-tech. High-tech architecture, wherever you look. And another watering hole over here. Hello, hello, how are you? Nice to see you. And just a wonderful, hi, how are you? A lot of beautiful cars here. Wow, is that the, they got that, how do you get down there? Wow, that's the bay down there. Holy cow, you can watch your car get fixed, huh? How do you... Nobody's gonna talk to me. I wanna go down there. Let's just go downstairs. Thank you, sir. Hello, hello, hello. What a place. Juan, you work here, Juan? Wow, you're a Porsche mechanic? Wow. We're just waiting for the elevator now to take us down to the maintenance bay. While we're waiting for the elevator, I'll just take a peek over here. Call me, Juan. I'll be right here. We'll come back over here. Look at this. Just fascinating. Just fascinating. Very hot today in Austin, 97 degrees. The homeless people were actually opening up the flaps on their tents. That's how hot it was. They needed the extra breeze that would... I guess this is going to really be holding us up here with this elevator. Maybe there should be a staircase instead of an elevator. This is really, it's really eating up time here. But I guess it'll be worth it when we get there. Go ahead, sir, it's okay. No staircase? I guess there's no staircase. There's no staircase, huh? Nobody's talking to me. Yeah. All right, we got it. Clean as a whistle. Brand new, like a brand new baby's butt. Look at this. Beautiful. That was Juan. He was sanitizing the inside of the elevator.
I've changed diapers in a long time.
After. What's that?
I don't like your analogy. You haven't changed diapers in a long time.
Oh, this is the wrong one. We want the service bay, don't we?
Oh, that's down. Yeah, we're going up.
Okay.
We're going on the roof, but we're going.
Wow, look at all the room. How many floors? You mind talking if you don't mind? Seven floors.
We want royalties on this video.
Wow, you guys are all Porsche owners, are you?
Yes.
Wow. Yeah, someday maybe. Whoa, look at this. Maybe I should start on. Maybe I should start on the roof and then move down. Yeah.
Right. It's not the roof, but this is where they have you see all the cars.
Right. Oh my word! This is going to be a long video, folks. So this is number six, huh? And there's the freeway.
Whoop.
Whoa! What's that?
It looks like a Porsche vending machine.
It sure does, doesn't it? Look at that nice color. That's a turquoise. Don't ask me how to spell turquoise. Look at this one. This is an old-fashioned one. Not too mad. 70s? Early 80s? You tell me. Now, all the information about Porsche, when it was started, who owns it, how many production cars or how many vehicles or units are produced every year, can be easily found on your laptop, your computer. I'm not going to even try to... What I'm going to do today is just kind of... These are encased. See, this is glass here. It's so clean, it looks like it's not even here. There's the traffic, see? The traffic is getting very, very heavy in Austin. Because Joe Rogan moved here, and now everyone else is moving here as well. And Elon Musk moved here. He's building a factory here. A lot of companies are leaving California because I don't know what's wrong with them. Anyway, so I'll put it back on the wide lens. And I guess we're gonna be fighting. Oh, here's another level down here. See the level down here? This is too exciting. Look at another nice turquoise, another nice blue. And look at these beautiful automobiles. I bet they're all for sale too. Everything's for sale. Is that a sticker price over there? I'm not going to be able to get over there. That's too skinny. And let me see if I can focus in on my truck. Where is that beautiful 1991 Ford? There it is. You see it right in the center there? Right there. Doesn't really fit in with all these other high-end vehicles, but that's what got me here. It's got four wheels and it keeps going. Well, let me get back to the wide lens. I'm trying to have my cold beverage and work these images as well. And there it is again. There's the right in the center of your screen between two white vehicles. If you look very closely, you'll even be able to see the bungee cord on the front of the vehicle. Can you see the bungee cord? That's just in case that latch loses contact with the catch, and that bungee cord will keep that front of my vehicle from the hood flying into my face and possibly causing a serious accident. Nice white one. White or beige? Ah, look at this. Look at this. I'm told all the executives from America are here celebrating the grand opening of this dealership. How I was invited to this event, you're probably all, hey, look, say hello, say hello, say hello, say hello, say hello. the reason I was, I received an invitation, even though I'm not a Porsche owner, is because the owner of the Vulcan Gas Company on 6th Street's father, I tried to get to say hello to him. Maybe he was in a meeting with the executives and he could not be disturbed. And that's how I got this invitation. Back in the elevator. Hi. Where are you guys going? Down? All the way to the service bay?
Yeah.
Oh, good. I haven't been there yet.
Yeah, that's where I'm at. What are you doing? Doing a blog?
Yeah, my YouTube channel.
Yeah.
You know, this is very interesting. It's very beautiful. I'm not a Porsche owner, though. I guess I'm a looky-loo. Now, what floor is this?
3.
Wow, I better get off at 3. I'll get off at 3. Hey, buddy, how you doing?
Yes, sir. How you doing?
This is number 3, huh?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Looks like the used lot.
The used car.
You'll see Porsche and you're like, eh, what is that, Chevrolet?
Wow, look at this. Holy cow. Now, a lot of my friends, I don't know if I have any friends that own Porsches. I guess I have some friends that own Porsches, but... Wow, look at them all. I'm just going to try to... What do they call that, a Landau top? Is that a Landau top? And that gentleman said these are used Porsches. There's a nice green one. Green, I'd like a green one. How cool would have a green one? You don't see many green ones. You know? How nice would that look on a rainy day? This one is on hold. Somebody wants this one. He's got the leather package, no doubt. Let's see if it's an automatic or a transmission. A standard. I can't tell. What is it? I think it's a standard. There it is. Wow, this place is just too much. If you can't find a Porsche here, it doesn't exist. Look at that nice detail on the seat. This is a white one. White is good if it's kept clean. It's gotta be spotless. This is a nice color too. This is like a bronze or a brown, a burnt brown, I think they call this. And here's another four-door, looks like. Yep, there was a market for it and they decided they were gonna go in that direction. They did very successfully. And it became popular for families, single guys who got married and had children and still wanted to drive a Porsche, opted for this model. Wow, look at this one. Oh, that's a Chevrolet right there. Holy cow. Look at this. This is a Camaro, Chevrolet. And there's the license plate. Porsche Austin. High-tech motor cars. So, you know, this is better than a car show right now, and it's free. What the hell is this, a Jaguar? Look at the Jaguar. Hey, that's Jaguar. It's gonna take me a long time. We got 18 minutes on this video. Here's a Corvette. Two Corvettes, a yellow one, and here's a silver one. Wow. They're kind of low to the ground, though, these Corvettes. It's like riding on a skateboard. And then to get in and out is kind of a situation if you've got a hip or knee problems or any kind of mobility issues. And also, when you go up and down driveways, you got to go real, real slow because you're going to catch the front of your vehicle on most driveways, retail stores, driveways. Here's a Cadillac. It was sold. Wow, somebody picked up a Cadillac. And somebody's gonna get a Cadillac. God, I'm sweating here. This is a Tesla, four-door Tesla. I have a friend, Brian Redband, the pod father. He has a Tesla. and my niece, the baby doctor, in Alexandria in Virginia, has a Tesla. And she loves it. Mercedes-Benz, Lexus. Wow, a Lexus. Who snuck the Lexus in here? Holy cow. Four-door Lexus. You can just imagine what the prices of these vehicles are. There's no sense of telling you or showing you. We all know they're more than 10,000 and less than 1 million. Oh, wow, what is this, Audi? Audi is Volkswagen manufactured. Lexus is a Toyota, is the high luxury model of Toyota, Lexus, and Audi is the high luxury model of Volkswagen, if I'm not mistaken. Here's a BMW, first BMW I think I've seen. And here's a vintage with a moonroof. These can really, really demand quite a price, even these older ones. This is a very common color. This is a 450 SLC. Is that a C? Yeah. And that's a beige. And then we have another Porsche in the corner. And this was the gate that we saw going down. And bear with me if you're still watching. We've got a... We still haven't been down in the bay. Another Porsche. Let's just come around here. Here's a yellow one. Nice. I wouldn't mind a yellow one. You know, on some vehicles it looks like a taxi, but other vehicles it looks just fine. I would have no problem driving a yellow Porsche like this. No problem at all. And here's even a kind of like a burnt orange. I hope I'm doing justice to these images in these vehicles. Kind of, I'm not saying I'm rushing, but I'm not, I can't afford to take your time and take my time. And I'll just spin around and head back to the elevator. Wow. Is there a stairs? I hope there's a staircase. I'm not gonna wait for the elevator if I don't have to. It's gotta be staircases. And here is some of the history of Porsche. What does he say? Here he is. This is the founder, Ferdinand Porsche. Life itself is a race marked by a start and a finish. It is what we learn during the race and how we apply it that determines whether our participation has had particular value. If we learn from each success and each failure and improve ourselves through this process, then at the end, we have fulfilled our potential and performed well. Wow. He wasn't kidding around, was he? And that's all about a car. Let's see if we can get the heck out of here in a staircase. I hope I don't get locked in the damn staircase. Yeah, okay. So let's go all the way up to the top. Forget the elevator. It's gonna take too long. This is stair level 4. Now what was on 4? 4 is more cars. Let's go all the way to the top. So I hope you're enjoying this presentation. It's kind of, we'll get down on the ground floor again. And you'll be able to see some of the beautiful vehicles. Here's 5. So we'll just go, God. Here's level 6. Thank God I found the stairs. All right. If you want to know what these are what they hook up when they want to hook up something. Okay, here's the roof. We made it. I hope we don't get stuck on the roof. So this is the roof. And the What time is it? It's 5:45. This event was from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. And this is the roof where they're storing some other vehicles. Here's a minivan. Somebody, I guess, traded in a Honda. They make good vans. If I was going to get a van, I'd like one of those. When I wasn't sure if I was going to get my truck back, I almost was looking at vans. Here's a Nissan. Mercedes-Benz. Porsche. Ferrari. Is that a Ferrari? It's a Porsche. Maybe that wasn't a Ferrari I saw. I don't know. I'm always under the gun. I'm always under the time. Here's another one. And you can actually, if you're ever driving on the freeway, when they shift gears and go different speeds, this thing in the back here, this, whatever they call it, it's not a skylight. Thank you for mentioning that. I couldn't remember skylight yesterday. Or was it the day before? I think it was yesterday, my walk and talk. This thing will come up and down. Here it is. You can see it. It's up now. And this is a spoiler. That's what they call that, a spoiler. That'll keep the car from flying off the road and becoming an airplane. And it goes up and down with the various speed of the vehicle and whatnot. Let's go on the side over here and see if we can get some nice views of Austin, Texas. I'm about 20 minutes from downtown. And there it is. I can't help it. I've got to zoom in. Where is it? Where is that vehicle? Yeah, I lost it. There it is. There it is. And I don't have air conditioning either because, I just don't use it. Don't have it. I think it might need to be serviced. I just never needed it in California. There's downtown Austin straight ahead. It. Those tall buildings, that's downtown. Okay, let's move along. We're on the roof of the largest Porsche dealership, perhaps in Texas, I don't know. You'll have to do your own research. I know it's the largest one in Austin. Could it be the largest one in Texas? Could it be the largest one in the world by square foot? I know it's the newest, that's for sure. Here's an old Porsche, look at this one. You see these in movies back in the 70s and whatnot. These are some cool, this particular model got discontinued though. They just did away with it. It was there and you saw it on the road and then all of a sudden it was gone. Turbo, Porsche. Beautiful. Hi. So they're just maybe some of these are trade-ins, who knows? And people are trading up to Porsches. Here's an Alfa Romeo, an Alfa Romeo, Romeo. That's Italian for you, huh? And Nissan, and there's Best Buy. Can you see Best Buy over there, way on the corner? Best Buy hanging in there. Despite Amazon. God, that woman had legs from here to forever. I don't know if you were able to see that. I saw it. Okay, let's get back inside and we'll just go until we get to the basement in 29 minutes. Air conditioning units, AC. Okay, that's it. I think we already did two floors. So, and the guy who owns this, we've been up here already, but I'll give you a look. See, we've been up here already. This is number 6. Level 6. The guy who owns this dealership, he's probably not living in a studio apartment or renting a room in Oak Hill with an Indian family. Here's number 5. 5 is empty. Very nice. This will be an easy one. Nothing on 5. So here we go. This is what firemen have to do when they train. They have to climb stairs. Many, many, many flights of stairs with a big dummy. Now, what is this? This is 4. I think we've done 4 already. 4? Have we done 4? Yeah, this is 4. Let's go. I want to show you the cars on the showroom floor. These other cars. I hope this leads right to the maintenance bay. Okay, here's 3. 3 we did. We know we did 3 because we talked about this gentleman over here. There he is. Very opinionated gentleman. Very opinionated about his cars. And he wasn't kidding around. Okay, so we're gonna move right along. We're descending now. This item here, if you don't know what this is, they use this to do what they have to do with that. And then here we go. And number 2. Okay, we're now number 2. So we know where we've been on number 2. There's another gin mill. So let's go down. And 1, we're going in the basement. That's where we're gonna go. Hello, gentlemen.
Hello there.
Got it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr.
Mayor. Is that the maintenance bay down there? Thank you.
Yes,
sir. Okay. Go ahead, sir.
I'm signing about all the momentum. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thanks. I appreciate it. All right. We're going to go down the maintenance bay now. That'll be the basement. And then after that, we'll show you the main floor. And there's another one of these things over here. Very important, these items right here. What they do with these is they do what they need to do to get that done. And then we just go right around and in the basement. You can always tell you're in a basement when you see ladders. For some reason, ladders are always kept in the basement. I've noticed that throughout my life. My whole life. There wasn't a life that I had that I didn't remember ladders in the basement. And this is no different or no, this is a great example of ladders in the basement. I mean, this is ladders in the basement in the dictionary would be a picture of this. Ladders in the basement. Unbelievable. Okay, we're in the basement and I am sweating like I was working in a Chinese laundry. Wow. Look at this. Look at this. Have you ever seen the bottom of a Porsche? Wow. Now, we got a calculator over here. We're gonna have to bring that around. That's gonna have to be changed. You're gonna need a new CCC valve, and we're gonna have to probably do another brake job on those. You're wearing thin on those. That's a sign of your, look at the way they seal the bottom. Seal the bottom. You don't want nothing going in there, which is nice. Very nice. And these are all the different devices they use. The oils, and the air, and the water. Air, electricity, water, oils. Computers. Look at that. This is, these guys get a lot of money too. Here's another one that's sealed all the way. Look at the way they seal the bottoms. They don't want nothing getting in there. And here's your gearbox. The engine, of course, is in the rear. And this is your gearbox. Yeah, I think our differential is wearing on the side. I think we're gonna have to replace that, Mr. Johnson. No, it won't be too expensive, but you better bring the title to your house. And wow, look at that. And there's the engine up there. See it? Wow. Let me see if I can get a shot of the engine. Can you see the engine? Can you see the engine? That's the engine compartment. And we're just going to keep moving along. We don't want to draw too much attention to ourselves. The kind of shirt I'm wearing right now. Wow, this guy's getting this. Just bring money. Oh my God, bring money. Go get your wife's jewelry box. Bring that in too. Oh my God, we've got some heavy maintenance here. A lot of R&R. You know what R&R stands for? Remove and replace. R&R. Also, it means rest and rest some more. But in what we're talking about, here we go again. We got air, electricity, water, oils. And look at all the bays. Wow, look at all the bays. Here's what they use for the exhaust, see? If they're running the vehicle inside, they'll use this machine right here to catch any exhaust so the workers aren't put to sleep prematurely. Just beautiful. I hope I'm doing justice with this, with these images. I'm doing my best. We're at 37 minutes. If you gotta go, you gotta go. You can watch it in two parts. This is too exciting for me. Oh, here's another guy that's gonna need a jewelry box. Call your father-in-law, tell him you need another loan. The Porsche's in the shop. I need another loan. Please, ask your father. Please, come on, honey, ask your father. I was nice to him the last time he came over for dinner. Ask him again. Just another 20 grand. Come on, he's not gonna miss it. He's worth $200 million, honey. Just ask him for $20,000. I wanna get the car out of the shop. Oh, look at this. Oh. They're doing some heavy-duty maintenance over here. And they got their computers they can look up. Here's your towing mechanism in case you need to. They have those on Mercedes-Benzes too, because they don't have any hooks like regular cars. So they cover it with that little disc, and then that's what the tow truck driver uses it to pull it out of the sand. Here's where they balance the wheels, and that's very important. And there's machines that do this and tell them exactly that the wheels are balanced properly. And there's a big engine. Look at the big engine right there. There's your Porsche engine. I'd be crazy not to show you this. You really have to be careful with these vehicles, because if you don't know how to drive a sports car, it will get away from you. It will get away from you. You have to know what you're doing. I only like to go about 70, not even 60. I'm gonna pretend I'm not trying to zoom in on that, but I'm zooming in on that. Sorry. Hello, sir. Unbelievable. I had to zoom in on that. I'm sorry. What am I going to do? Try to pretend I don't see it? Pretend you don't see it? Pretend nobody sees it? I guess when you're dressed like that, it's because you want people to see it. I mean, what are you, crazy? You know? It's not a question of being morally defunct. It's a question about being alive and having your veins pumping oxygen and blood and living life to the fullest. That's what it's about. It had nothing to do with, and this is coming from a guy that's in Hussy magazine. So I should just shut my mouth right now. But I hope you guys are enjoying this. This is the maintenance bay on the lowest level. And we'll go take a look at the engine. Oh, here's a license plate for you. Wow. There she goes. It's quite a dress. You think she got a discount on that dress? Because there's not a lot of dress there. There's the engine. This is the engine. This is a turbo prop. There's your transmission. And that hooks into your gearbox. This is a look at all that. Something else. Looks heavy, huh? Gee whiz. Looks. And there's the engine bay. And your transmission. And there's your differential right there. That broke on my Datsun 200ZX. And that broke once on me. I had a Nissan 200SX. And this is what cut loose on me once. I had to go to the junkyard. And we found one. My brother Jay and I, we put it back on. And it was wonderful. Yeah, you a Porsche owner? What kind do you have? Three? Wow.
I have a Carrera, a 911 Carrera S, a special edition.
Wow.
No, el otro es un R8. Es que tenía tres, pero bueno. I had three, pero sold.
Wow. This is your first time at the dealership, this brand new dealership?
No, I've been here. I have about five Porsches.
Five?
And I tell you, from my excellent customer care.
Where's your accent from? Where are you from?
So I came yesterday.
Wow.
Some of the Porsche have built beautiful cars for a long. There are six cylinders, and that's it.
Right, right.
The four cylinders and that leaking oil, no matter what you do. The electric, they have not invented those. They are not invented. They rush to put those cars in the market and that thing.
You have any other vehicles or just Porsche? That's it? That's all you drive is Porsche?
No, I have a Toyota.
Toyota. Yeah, I have a Toyota.
A reliable.
Yeah. 91.
Yeah, I
have a Toyota pickup.
I have a car which is very special, special edition. But and the R8, they don't make it anymore. White, black. And I have a Toyota which is trustable van.
Right. You know you're gonna get where you're going.
Those things?
Here she comes again. Here she comes.
Anything electric, hybrid, stay away from
it. Hybrid?
Any four-cylinder Porsche, and any hybrid Porsche, stay away from
it. Right.
Or electric Porsches. They were not ready.
Gee whiz. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
I don't know what happened to this one.
Yeah, it looks like an engine change. Or an engine... Maybe you hate to see that, huh? That's going to be a couple of dineros, huh?
$200 an hour.
$300 an hour?
$200
an hour. $200? Wow. $200 an hour. Jeez. Plus parts. Holy cow. Nice talking to you, sir. I'll see you now.
They're very expensive. The Toyota is 130.
I know, even the Toyotas are getting expensive. So long now. So we're gonna make our way into the main showroom where we started, where we saw a lot of people. Now look, the customers over here can actually watch their vehicle being maintained in these windows up here. Just like in the operating room, where you can watch them pulling out your brother's prostate with the robot, you can actually, oh, here we are again. Hello, 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 hi. Air, electricity, water, Earls. And see up here, just like in the operating room, they can watch their Porsche being operated on. Here's a race car. There she is again. Oh my word. What is this, Las Vegas? Holy cow. I'm gonna take the stairs, but I don't wanna get in trouble. I'm already in trouble. My whole life has been trouble. I've been going up against the current my whole life. And then I bought a Porsche. There's the bay. Look at all the bays. That guy was nice. He was very nice, that guy. And two bays over here that we forgot. They have to get routine maintenance, and they have to, they get to get brake jobs and everything. And they're very temperamental. These are not, you can buy it. It's like a horse. You can afford the horse, but can you afford the horse's new shoes? Can you afford to feed that horse? Can you afford the horse's lodging? Where are you gonna keep the horse? Can you afford the veterinarian bills for that horse? So Porsche, in a lot of ways, is the same analogy, where you just don't buy it and drive it and forget about it. It needs constant attention, and it needs dinero. It needs money. And let's go. Here's the lattice again. God, this is, what are the chances of me seeing lattice like this in a basement? Unbelievable. You know, it's uncanny sometimes how life works out, you know? Oh, there's that thing again. This is a very important device right here. What they do here is this enables them to do what they have to do. Yeah. Okay, we're going up in the showroom. 47 minutes. This is a long video. If I was a fireman right now, I'd say, how tall is this building? My God, can we use a ladder? Is there an elevator that works? And this is over here. We were outside. Now we're gonna come over here and see if we can find the owner. Here's all the sales offices. Here's this one over here. So I think we'll be finishing up pretty soon for you guys and gals who are getting antsy. We'll be finishing up soon. I'm gonna see if I can't locate. Here's your Porsche car seats for the little ones. All sorts of Porsche accessories, pens and watches, cufflinks, tie pins, belts, wallets, keychains, lanyards, you know, the things you put your ID on when you're at the, wherever you go. Sunglasses, Porsche design sunglasses, $375. So that was nice. They made it easy. They're all the same price. Some sports shirts, $55. Wow, there's a little Porsche for you. If daddy's got a Porsche, baby Bobby Lou needs a Porsche too. Get Bobby Baby Lou a Porsche. Yeah, the Porsche hats. Maybe I'll come back here and get a Porsche hat. I have a Toyota hat. Golf bag, a Porsche golf bag. Look at that. For you golfers out there. $45 for the racing Porsche. Look at this couple. They're very happy. She's happy, but she's looking the other way, so I don't know how happy she could be. Maybe she saw a friend. Now your shirt. This dealership has it all. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if there was a massage parlor in this dealership where you could go and get a back rub. Maybe a happy ending. I don't know. They got everything else here. Wow, this is nice. Maybe I should get one of these. And they have gift bags, too. I'll show you the gift bags before we leave. Here's some Porsche glasses. If you want to drink and drive, I guess you take a Porsche glass with you. Then you just get knocked out. These are the gift bags. See the gift bags? Hopefully I'll get it. I better grab one before they're all gone. Hey boss, how you doing? I'm gonna put mine over here. I'll come and get it later. I'll come and get it later. I don't want to carry it around with me. Here comes some food. Whoa, the shrimp. Can I get one? Wow, look at this. Unbelievable. Holy cow. Thank you, sir. Sure.
Yes, sir.
Wow, thank you, sir.
All right, you enjoy yourself.
Wow, look at this. Look at that. I'm gonna eat it. I'm gonna eat it right now. All the gift bags. A lot of gift bags. This is where they can watch their vehicle being maintained through the windows we talked about. And I'm gonna wrap it up here. Nick, hi. Nick, say hello. Can you introduce me to your father?
Yeah.
He was in a meeting with some people before.
Yeah, that's the president of Porsche.
Wow.
I'm gonna see about the father.
How you been, buddy? You're looking great, huh?
I've been good. I haven't come. What are you looking for?
All right. That's Nick. Nick is the one who owns the Austin Gulf, Vulcan, the Vulcan gas company. And his father is the owner. Hi, how are you? Yeah, that's Nick. Nick can't say no. I'm gonna be looking around.
There's a service staff down here just for the service.
Yeah, I, this is the last part of my presentation. The main floor. What a place, man.
That's crazy. Spent a lot of time on it.
Jeez, it's just beautiful. Look at all the stuff that you can get here. So Nick is going to go look for his father. I'd like to meet his father. I bet there are a lot of women here who want to meet his father. Nick's father, I'm told, is the owner. These are the landlords, whatever the, you know what I mean. Hey buddy, you want to say hello?
Hey,
you want to say hello?
Good to see you, Brian.
He's looking for him now.
Yeah, I was looking over here.
Great. So we're just gonna follow it around and see what we can see. It's very busy. This is a big event. And everybody's just excited about the cars, and some people are excited about, and the cars too. Yeah, here's the bicycle we were talking about. Wow, Here's the yellow again. I tell you, I wouldn't mind a yellow car. Who's going to say no to a yellow Porsche? Nobody. The red one? Wow. Look at this. Look at this. Holy cow. That's the spoiler now. That's the spoiler. I'm going to try to get this gentleman to give us a word about this vehicle. This is a very, very, this vehicle goes 0 to 60 very fast. 0 to 60 fast. I mean fast. Oh, the car. I mean the car. Yes. Do you mind saying a few words about the vehicle? Oh, he's a race car driver?
He is the driver of this car.
Wow. Hi, how are you?
I'm Brian Holtzman.
Nice to meet you.
You're the driver of this vehicle?
Yes, sir.
Just briefly, I know there's a lot to talk about. There's so many things involved. Just summarize what you do, who you are, and a little about the vehicle, if you don't mind.
Absolutely, sure. So my name is Riley Dickinson. I'm the driver number 53 Porsche Austin 992 GT3 Cup car this year for the Porsche Carrera Cup North America. So obviously this year, as you can see, it's the all new 992 GT3 Cup car. So if you look inside here, you can tell and see that everything with this car, this vehicle has been optimized since the previous generation 991.2 Cup car. So if we walk around here.
So this is high tech all the way, high tech.
It is. I mean, there's everything on the previous generation model. It's been optimized in the 992 model.
How fast you get this up to 200 miles an hour or something?
No, only 164 is fast, and that's at Road America. So as you can see, there's been a lot of things that they've taken out of the front foot just to minimize weight and whatnot. They've added quite a few air scoops through here just to optimize performance as well. And a lot that they've done, pushed behind the scenes to make this car what it truly is. And everything that you see here, it all gets pulled into the street version 992 as well. So there's a lot of things that we've been able to develop across the world, not just in our series, but 992s across the world. We've been able to develop and battle test to roll right into the street market.
Amazing. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Wow. Wow. All right, I think that's it, folks. I think that's it. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. I think I'm going to cut it here at about an hour. I hope you enjoyed the Austin Porsche dealership and everybody inside. Come and get your Porsche. Come and get your Porsche. And enjoy yourself. It's a packed house. What time is it now? 6:15. The DJ DJ's sounds are bumping. I'm going to try to get a little bit more appetizers, another beverage of my choice. Enjoy your weekend. Tomorrow is Friday. Today is Thursday. And wear your seatbelt. Keep it under 60 or 70. Use your directional. Do not text and drive. Use your car seat for the little ones. And have a safe journey no matter where you go.